So where were we? We found out energy in the nth orbit for the atom in for the electron in hydrogen atom is what? Minus of 13.6 by n square electron volt. Suppose it is not hydrogen, it is hydrogen like atom, then what will be the energy? This into z is what? 5. This is for hydrogen atom. For hydrogen like atom, hydrogen like atom again has a single electron only, energy in the nth orbit will be 13.6 by n square into z square electron volt. Fine, where z is the atomic number. Let us solve few questions on it. The difference of 2.3 electron volt, there is a difference between two energy levels in an atom. Okay, you have to find out what frequency will be emitted if electron makes a transition from first level to the other level. Getting it? Apply Bohr's third postulate. What does it say? Difference in energy will be equal to a photon emitted, and photon's energy is h into mu. So mu is asked, delta E, which is equal to 2.3 electron volt, should be this. Getting it? So basically mu is equal to what? 2.3 into 1.6 10 is for minus 19 divided by 6.6 into 10 raised to power 34. You can roughly make it 4, and you can roughly make it 24. This is 0.6. So this is 0.6 into 10 raised to power, this is how much? 15. So 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Fine. So this is direct application of the Bohr's atomic model, third postulate. Now if you talk about energy levels, I mean this is not part of theory, I'm just analyzing the energy levels of the electrons, then you'll see that what formula says that energy in the nth level is minus 13.6 by n square ev. Fine. So what is the least possible of number, principal quantum number n? 1. So n is 1, this is the least n. For the least n, energy will be minimum or maximum?
Maximum.
Minimum, there is a negative sign.
Oh, yeah.
Every time you forget negative sign. It is minimum. For n equal to 1, it is minimum. So n equal to 1 is also called ground state. You can't go below that. Fine. So least possible energy happens when n equal to 1 or when electron in its ground state. Okay. So E1 is what? Minus of 13.6 eV. E2 is what? Minus 13.6 divided by 2 square electron volt. How much is this? Could you calculate how much is
this?
No, exact.
4.9.
Why you guys are so lazy? Why can't you just calculate? Minus 3.4 electron volt? If you shy away from calculation, you will be completely shattered when you write the JEE exam. Okay, they test you on calculation also. And especially these chapters, which are easy. They'll put some difficult calculations. Okay. Find out what is third energy level, how much it is. Minus 13.6 divided by 3 square.
Approximately
1.51 electron volt. E4, you get minus of 0.85 electron volt, like this you will get. Okay, so if you draw energy level diagram, you will have least possible energy for n equal to 1, which is minus of 13.6 electron volt. Fine. Then you have for n equal to 2, you'll see that there is a big gap between n equal to 1 and n equal to 2 energy. This is minus 3.4. How much is this gap? 10.2 electron volt. Fine. Next energy level is minus 1.5. Okay. So energy level, this is n equal to 3. That is minus 1.51. Next is what? Minus 0.85. One thing you will notice that the difference in energy is reducing. Okay, slowly and slowly the next level is coming closer and closer. So n equal to 5 will be further closer, n equal to 6 will be more close. Fine. So like this there will be like till n tends to infinity. I mean slowly and slowly they coincide. So after a point it doesn't matter what is the quantum number. Getting it? And anyways, if you give it large enough energy, energy tends to zero, right? From this, energy is going towards zero, and as soon as energy goes to zero, electron is free. It is not bounded. Fine. So that is what this is. You can say energy level where energy is zero, and then the atom ionizes or electron leaves the atom. Fine. So this is how you can see the energy diagram is. Now, here is the thing. If electron is in n equal to 4 level, how many wavelengths it can emit? It is n equal to 4 level, so it can directly go to 4 to 1, one wavelength. It can jump from one stable orbit to another stable orbit. Or it can go to 2, or it can jump to 3, or once this jumps to 3, then 3 will go to 2, and this will go like this, or this. So how many? There's one more. Which one? An electron is at n equal to 4. You can't increase it. Which one? This. This is gone, this is gone. No.
No, what do you call it? It can go from 2 to 1.
Yeah,
2 to 1.
Oh, wait,
no, 2 to 1 is here, right? 1, 2, 3. Oh, 6 are already there. So 6. Fine. So you can see 6 wavelengths can be emitted if electron is at n equal to 4 excited state. Fine. In fact, when electron is at n equal to 4, it means what? You can choose out of 4, you can choose any 2, transition will happen. So basically 4 C2 ways transition will happen, right? So if electron is in nth excited state, so it will be n C2 number of wavelengths will be emitted. So if you just know how many wavelengths are getting emitted, you will be able to find out which excited state it is in. Fine. So this will be equal to n into n minus 1 divided by 2. Okay? Any doubt till now? See, there is a mention of how you can arrive at Bohr's second postulate, mvr equal to nh by 2 pi, assuming electron is of deep Broglie wave. We have done this when we studied the dual nature. Okay? It goes like this. This is suppose electron orbit. Okay, this is the electron orbit, and if electron is a wave, it will travel like a wave, like this. It will travel in a way that here it will join in phase. Okay, so basically the total path should be what? Integer times wavelength. Why? Because you can check from here to here one wavelength, from there till here another wavelength, from here till here one more wavelength, and from here to here one more. Fine. So you can count number of wavelengths. So if it has to merge here exactly in phase, the total path should be integer times wavelength. Otherwise, it will not be in sync with its previous movement. Fine. So total path is what? 2 pi r this should be equal to n into lambda. Fine. And what is lambda according to de Broglie? H by p, which is linear momentum, so it become mv. So you can get mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. So what de Broglie has done, that coincides with the Bohr model. Fine. Now see, the theory in this chapter is very limited. So we are done with the theory. Let's see a few questions that can be asked from this particular chapter. We'll first touch upon the NCERT questions, because that's how it should start. So now the questions will be on entire chapter, wherever. What are you doing?
I thought I passed my phone.
Phone is the most precious thing nowadays. You should not lose your phone. Everything is in the phone, all the private conversation and everything, your bank password. Yeah, of course, few games which you play all day. You play games on phone? No. Don't die. Okay, anyways, energy in the ground state for a hydrogen atom's electron is minus 13.6 electron volt. What is the kinetic and potential energy in this ground state? Kinetic energy and potential energy. How many are there? Oh, sorry, how much? Done? How much is the kinetic energy? 13.6. How much is the potential energy?
Minus 6.4.
How much?
Half of this.
So when you add kinetic energy, potential energy, it should come out to be this or not?
Yeah.
So is it coming? Potential energy is double of this. Kinetic energy is minus of this. We have done this. Okay. See, you are facing trouble because you are not able to accept that okay, energy is negative. This is negative. If you double it, it decreases. It goes down. Okay, next question. Hydrogen atom, which is initially at the ground state, as if at n equal to 1 it is. Okay, it jumps to n equal to 4. Find out, see why it will jump? Because it absorbs photon, right? You have to find out wavelength and frequency of photon. Wavelength and frequency of the photon. Quickly do it. Those who are watching it online, I am Dheeraj from CENTUM Academy. We are located in Bangalore. And if you want to get in touch with us, this is the phone number. Okay? You guys are stuck? See, this, you can take it like this. 1 by lambda is 1.097, 10 is power 7. Into 1 by what? Which square? 1 square minus 1 by 4 square, which is 16. Okay? Once you simplify this, you will get the value of lambda. How will you get frequency? Multiply this with speed of light. C by lambda. So if you first it is easy to get frequency, you know. Just multiply with C. That is the frequency. Okay? So frequency, which is C by lambda, is 3 into 10 to the power 8, 1.097, 10 to the power 7, into 15 by 16. So you will be able to get the frequency from here. Okay? Any doubt on this? Any doubt? See, it's all about calculation many a times in physics. So you have to be very, very good with numbers, and having good with number is an art. Don't think that it is donkey's work. It is not something which is respectful. It is probably the most respectful thing among mathematicians, being good with numbers. And some of the highest paying jobs, they only get it. So practice a lot of calculations.